I'm just doing a overview of integration parts. Now I'm going to start the types. Second one is that. Second one. Use the substitutions. So this is the solution for the first one. Yeah, substitute sin inverse x as theta. You can clear the first one. Anybody is copying it? Rohan, done. Second one is a problem where you realize that you may have to use integration by parts twice. So x is sin theta, which implies dx is cos theta d theta. So it becomes theta square cos theta d theta. So this is u, algebraic, trigonometric. So u square, integration of cos theta is sin theta, minus derivative of theta square with respect to theta is 2 theta, sin theta d theta. Now again we can apply IVP over here. This is u, this is v. So theta square sin theta minus 2 times. Theta, integration of sin theta is minus cos theta. Okay. Minus minus plus. Integration of cos theta is sin theta back. When you open the brackets, it becomes theta square sin theta plus 2 theta cos theta minus 2 sin theta plus c. This example was given to you just to realize that you may have to apply integration by parts more than once also in a given problem. Replacing theta back, again, that may be a challenge. So theta is sin inverse x, so this is x sin inverse x whole square. Plus 2 theta is again sin inverse x. Cos theta, if I am not wrong, will be under root 1 minus x square. Minus 2x plus c. So with a fair bit of an idea about how integration by parts works, we'll start taking some special integrals or types which are based on this concept. Okay, Tanvi, clear? Sneha? Sayuja, clear? Okay, so using integration by parts, we have some more special integrals. We already saw some set of special integrals. Now we'll have some more special integrals. There are three special integrals which will be very useful for us. One is under root x square plus a square. Another is under root x square minus a square. And another one is under root a square minus x square. Let me just solve the first one so that you can take care of the second, third one. Now there are two ways to solve the first one. One is by using trigonometric substitution. Another is without using that. Which one you want? With substitution without substitution? With substitution. Okay. Now here, with substitution, the favorite substitution here is x is a tan theta because of the presence of the term x squared plus a squared. Which means dx will become a secant square theta d theta. So when you substitute, x square plus a square will become a sec theta into a secant square theta, which makes it as a square secant cube theta. Okay. Now secant cube theta, let me call this as I. Let me work on secant cube theta. I can write secant cube theta as sec theta into sec square theta. I'll take this as u and I'll take this as v. Even though both are trigonometric functions, the one which is easier to integrate is sec square. So IVP gives me sec theta, integration of secant square is tan, minus derivative of secant theta is sec theta tan theta into again a tan, you will make it tan square. Correct me if I'm wrong. Correct? Let me write it in next step, else Apurva will not understand. Okay. Can I write this tan square theta as secant square theta minus 1? By the way, let me tell you, this is I all the way. If you expand it over here, do you realize that you will get minus secant cube theta plus integral of sec theta? What is this?
I.
So I has got, we have got I back again. So this I can write it as I. I will send it to the other side, what will become? 2i. Do we know the integration of sec theta? Yes, by God's grace we are aware of that. So which is ln sec theta plus tan theta. So I is going to be half of this, isn't it? Okay. Now by the way, I cannot leave my answer in terms of theta, because theta is something which I have introduced in the problem. I need to replace it back in terms of x. Now tan theta is x by a. So what is sec theta then? Under root 1 plus x by a whole square. Okay. I would like to clear some. Should I erase this part of it?
Yeah.
Now this part I want, because this is my final expression. So I'm going to substitute this over here. Can I erase this middle part? So my final answer is going to be a square times I. I is half sec theta tan theta plus ln mod of sec theta plus tan theta. And we need to replace our sec theta with under root 1 plus x square by a square into tan theta with x by a. Again, same thing over here, x by a plus under root of 1 plus x square by a square. Okay. Now, let's do one thing. Can I do this as x square plus a square by a square? Here also, I can do x square plus a square by a. So you can do. Okay. Now let's multiply a square throughout. I'll get x by 2 under root of x square plus a square, because a square will get cancelled. Here I will get a square by 2 ln x plus under root x square plus a square. Please note that minus ln a plus c will become another c. So this becomes your final answer for the first one. In a similar way, please do the second and the third. If you already know how to do it, you can skip it also.
So can you show the substitution?
Yeah, what substitution will you use if at all you're using substitution in the second one? X as a c theta. X as a c theta or a cosec theta. Both of them will work.
Can you also show the non-substitution
method? Non-substitution method. Good. Was it derived at the school?
No, this was derived at the school.
But with substitution. Without substitution, I'll show you. By the way, while doing this, you learn how to integrate sec cube theta. That can also come as a separate question. Integration of sec cube x or sec cube theta. You can do it by integration by parts. Okay, so without substitution, if you want, I'll do it. Without substitution, we have to write this integral as under root of x square plus a square into 1. Because we have to generate two functions at least to apply integration by parts. And if there is nothing, you can put a 1.
इसका कोई नहीं इसका तो वन तो होते ही
treat this as u treat this as v so it will be let's say I call it as I so I will be equal to u times integral of v which is x minus derivative of u will be x by under root x square plus a square into x okay x into x will become x square now listen to this step very carefully this is the most critical step since there is an x square plus a square what I will do yeah I'll add a square and subtract a square correct the benefit of doing this is I can individually take it as two different integrals this by this and this
so what is the point of the substitution method we did last day
what is the point of not
substitution no the substitution method is not the point of
substitution now this and this gets cancelled now what is this term I again so I is equal to x under root x square plus a square this you can replace by with I okay I goes on the other side becomes 2i now is this term familiar to you
yeah
what is the answer ln of x plus under root x square plus a square special integrals so my final answer I can say it's plus a square ln x plus under root x square plus a square don't forget to divide by 2 because it was 2i so this is going to be your answer without substitution try the second one out I'm giving you 2 minutes don't have much time done second one and
integral of the same thing had it been in the denominator. 1 by root a square minus x square integral is sine inverse x by a so sine inverse x square. This is what told to you. Questions based on this? Yeah.
Why is the protein is moving?
Sorry?
Why is the protein is
moving? Because nobody is following it. I can only see 5, 6 views every day. Okay. Just a simple problem to start with. Evaluate. Under root of. Integral of under root of. 2x square minus 3x plus 1. So my suggestion here would be first take the 2 common out from the under root, which will come out as under root. So x square minus 3x by 2 plus half. Now try to complete a square here within the root, so it will be x minus 3 by 4 whole square minus 9 by 16 plus 1 by 2. 1 by 2 I am writing it as 8 by 16. So it becomes minus 1 by 16, which is. So it becomes of the special integral type x square minus a square form. So your answer will be x by 2. This is x by 2. Under root. The function which is this. I've seen many people writing this expression, but remember this expression has come from this expression, so you can just copy it on this expression. Now, minus a square by 2. Minus a square by 2 will be minus 1 by 32. Ln of x, this is your x, plus under root. Not doing simplification here because you know how to do it. So basically, just to clear the idea of how to convert this to the special integral and then apply the reverse chain rule. Moving on to the most important type of question which comes under integration by parts. This is probably the most important type that you will get. Integration of the form okay. Now first we'll derive the result for this so that we can use that result directly everywhere. To solve this type of problem, first we break this integral as sum of two integrals, one having e to the power x f of x, other having e to the power x f dash x. Okay. Don't disturb this part, let it be as such. In this part, I'll take this as u and take this as v. Even if I don't know what is my function, I can always take it as u because exponential is always at the base of that Liat rule. So it's u integral of e to the power x is e to the power x minus derivative of f of x is f dash x integral of e to the power x is e to the power x plus copy the same term below, they will get cancelled, leaving you with e to the power x f of x plus c. So you can directly use this result for this type of cases. But the problem is that the question given to you will not be in such a clear-cut fashion that they will tell you this is function and this is its derivative. You will have to manipulate because they will be closely intertwined. So you will have to separate them out. Let's take few questions based on this thing.